Welcome to sports, everyone, in the final Channel 9 and Hy-Vee football patrol of the regular season. We begin with our game of the week. Despite having losing records into tonight's contest, the winner of the Lee's Summit North, Lee's Summit Showdown, would advance to the playoffs. And it was a very emotional night for me, first whacking a car with a sledgehammer to raise money for the robotics team of Lee's Summit, and then presenting a Halloween necklace to a beautiful young lady. Now to the game. Let's go to the first quarter. Lee Summit's quarterback is Corbin Bergstresser. He's going to take it 42 yards into the end zone for a touchdown. The extra point will be good. 7-0 Tigers on top, and that is going to fire up the crowd. Bergstresser's next big play is this one. A pass to King Frazier. He goes to the right side, travels some 28 yards before he is stopped. That will set up a 42-yard field goal into the win by Kyle Gross. It's going to be now 10-0 Lee's Summit. The last play of the half was an exciting one. Lee's Summit North quarterback Caleb Cole looks like he might have a shot at taking this all the way to the house, but a touchdown saving tackle by Ladarius Whitehead saves the touchdown. The final score in a good golf ball game, Lee's Summit 24, Lee's Summit North 21. So the Tigers advancing to next week's playoffs. Now our football patrol rolls on in Kansas, Olathe South versus Olathe North. Karen Kornacki was there.
Olathe North, already district champions, looking for the outright Sunflower League title with a win over Olathe South tonight. Eagles opening drive, it's all James Franklin. Number 30 caps it off with a 6-yard touchdown. The try for two is no good, it's 6-0. North's next drive, the Eagles moving the ball with a little wildcat offense. 4th and 2, Victor Simmons picks up 22 yards. Olathe North is set up on the 21. A couple plays later, quarterback David Blazevic with a 10-yard pass to Adonis Saunders. That's good for 6. Add a 2-point conversion by Franklin, and North led 14-0. As for the final score, Olathe North won 48-7. And here in Blue Valley, it's North versus Northwest, but it's senior night for North, and so they wear funny hats. And I guess you could say, I fit right in the middle of them. But hats off to the Huskies in the first half. Tim Park on a 13-yard run up the middle for a touchdown. Northwest took the lead 35-3. But North answered right back. Danny Dolan scrambles, looking for a target. He finds Sam Jones on a 17-yard scoring strike. The Mustangs cut the lead 35-10. As for the final score, Blue Valley Northwest won 49-32. Now let's go to Nick Griffith on the Missouri side.
Great evening for a little chopper ride. On board News Chopper 9, bringing you first up the game from William and Jewell College. It's Liberty's last regular season game altogether, we'll say, as the Blue Jays will split into two schools beginning next year. Tonight they're hosting Blue Spring South, and the Jays come out flying. First possession of the game, Kevin Van Egdom hits the home run ball to Jake Matry on the other end. 25-yard strike. Liberty all cheers early on. They lead it 7-0. And now the Blue Jays defense stepping it up. Todd Bruce makes the play in the backfield. Blue Springs South, they did go up at one point in the second half, 15-14. But in the end, Liberty just too much. They improved to 8-2 overall, 3-0 in district play. Jays soar over the Jags, 42-28, your final.
Next up from News Chopper 9, St. Pius versus O'Hara, battle of the Catholic schools. Who would win this one? O'Hara trying to repeat as district champs. St. Pius with some other ideas in mind.
Pius keeping it close early on, but here comes O'Hara's Raphael Spencer, quick to the outside, eventually dragged down inside the 10-yard line. That would set up this. T.J. White back to pass, sets up, coming back weak side into double coverage. It doesn't matter. Aaron Stubblefield pulls it in. Nice catch. O'Hara all over St. Pius in a dominating victory. Now here's a look at more Football Patrol scores from around the area.
One other score just called in. It was Blue Springs beating Columbia Rockridge 49-14. And thanks to everyone who called in with the scores. And congratulations to all the teams advancing to the playoffs.